Abiodun, if you look at them, you have somebody like Ahmadu Ahidjo, who was the first president of Cameroon. Now, class, who do you think was the first president of Cameroon? Falimatu. Who was the first president of Cameroon? What? What were you doing? How would an HIV/AIDS Muslim girl like you know the answer? I don't blame you. Your mother and your father were never students before they died of HIV/AIDS. Stupid girl. Come on, class, shame her.
Shame! Shame!
It's been 10 years now since my parents died and I was diagnosed of HIV/AIDS. People have rejected me and now regarded me as an outcast. Even in school, where I thought I would be accepted, I have been rejected. I am regarded as an HIV/AIDS spreading machine.
Falimatu. How are you, Falimatu?
I have not been seeing you in school any longer. Why are you staying away from school, Falimatu?
Sir, I used to love school. I always wanted to become a woman who will impact the world positively, fight poverty and promote gender equality. But sir, I don't think I will still hope to do all of this. Sir, I don't feel free in class. My teacher and mates regard me as an outcast. Sir, please tell me, is it my fault I was born with this killer disease? Be honest with me, sir. If you were in my place, will you be able to go back to school?
My daughter, I understand how you feel, but you have to know that every great destiny is faced with great opposition. You should also know that no one in the entire world can do a better job of being you than you. You have amazing dreams, plans, and ambitions. And unless you rise above these challenges, you cannot succeed. Go inside and put on your uniform and let us go to school. Don't worry, I will handle the situation. Just go in and put on your uniform and let us go to school.
Thank you, sir.
Insulting Falimatu will be severely punished. Yes, she is HIV positive, but you must love and treat her with care. She is part of you. Have I made myself clear?
Yes, sir.
Now apologize to her.
Falimatu.